Hey, what is up, guys? Shady Wags with Got Your Back Gaming. And I have to admit, until I unlocked Galalia, I was really struggling with Battleborn. I now have her almost completely unlocked, and I want to share with you some of my strategies that I've used to have some pretty decent games. On a scale, I would rank her somewhere between Wrath and Montana, coming in with decent attack damage and tanking abilities. But with the right equipment and by leveling her up, you can push her closer to Wrath in terms of damage output. I feel like in most one-on-one situations, she does hold the upper hand, especially when she gets into the middle of her helix. Although I would recommend running with a group at all times, this is where she is at her strongest. She is not as slow as Montana, but I did find myself having issues with chasing down the faster characters. Galalia is an extremely versatile character, and I'm going to show you by picking the right Helix power-ups, you can turn her from a up-in-your-face death-dealing machine into a long-range support healer. First, let's go through her attacks and skills. Her passive ability is Corruption, which deals up to 20 damage per second and steals health from enemies standing within the Corruption field when it's active. This is the Corruption meter, and as you attack and use your skills, this meter will grow and she will become corrupted. You can see the field on the ground. That is the field of Corruption. And when enemies stand in that field, they are going to start receiving damage. Her primary attack is the Wraith's Greatsword, which is two strong strikes and then a series of quick strikes.
Collector A secured.
Her secondary is her shield block, which can absorb up to 1,000 incoming damage. The shield is going to allow you to push in close to enemies without taking damage, and it also gives you the opportunity to tuck tail and run if you need to.
Collector C lost.
She also has a short-range offhand shield bash. Her first skill is Shield Throw. When it hits an opponent, it does 200 damage and stuns an enemy for 2 seconds. If a guy is just standing there, I use this as my leadoff skill, and it allows you to make up distance. If someone is strafing, do not throw it. You're going to miss, and you're going to be without your shield, so just raise your shield to block damage and move in. The Shield Throw is also a good way to stop runners and finish an enemy when their health is low. The second skill is Desecrate, which curses the ground beneath her feet, causing damage to enemies that stand within it. This is best used in large, confined group fights, or against players who are going to charge in and stand with you. Do not use this against fast, ranged characters. It's just going to be a waste because they're going to run away. If you are one-on-one against a fast, ranged character, what you can do is lead off with the shield stun, run up and hit Desecrate, now circle behind them and keep them in the field. Another time I would use it is when you have a character pinned in a corner. Her ultimate skill is Abyssal Form, where she sinks down in the ground, dealing 125 damage to the area over 4 seconds. She takes reduced damage, so she can still be hit and killed in this form. And while she is in this form, she regenerates 250 health. I use this two different ways. The first way is if I'm fighting up close with a guy, and it's going to be close, I go ahead and hit it and get the kill. But the way I use it most of the time is as a method of escape from a bad situation. If you're in a fight that is going sour, I go ahead and hit Abyssal Form, and most of the time when people see you sink into the ground, they run away. This gives you the opportunity to go the other way, heal up, and wait for some teammates. Now on to the Helix power-ups. These are going to be the power-ups that I take when I play capture maps. They're generally going to focus on damage output. On the first level, I always take Calamity. This totally shuts down healing for 5 seconds and is huge. It gives you plenty of time to kill a player. If you run into a situation where it's you against two players and one of them is a healer, go for the player that is not the healer. If that healer is focused on healing the other player, and you hit Desecrate, this will give you the chance to kill him before the healer even notices that his heals are not landing. Again, it's the same reasoning behind Mark of the Feeble. Stopping that player from healing for 5 seconds gives you plenty of time to kill him. On the third helix, I take Gnashing Bash. This is another damage over time. It's quick to throw out there, and we're just stacking damage. If you do not have that, take Sentinel Stance for 2 reasons. As you move in closer to players, they normally are firing on you. This is just going to make you stronger as long as you have that shield up. And the second reason, when I play capture maps, I'm almost never at full health. So taking It's Dangerous to Go Alone would just kind of be a waste. Moving on to level 4, I take Forsaken Ground. Again, this is just upping the damage of Desecrate. At level 5, if you do not have Anti-Hero unlocked, take Last Light for the health regen. By taking Anti-Hero at level 5, this is where you start moving closer to Wrath's damage output, gaining up to a 35% attack speed bonus. Anti-Hero will turn you into a killing machine. At level 6, I take Forsaking Others, and the reason why, if I'm running away or at the end of a fight, or even during a fight, if I throw that shield and pick it back up, this gives me a way to get some health back. At level 7, I take Mirror Knight. I'm always putting up my shield to block incoming range damage, and if a player throws some powered up ranged attack, there is a chance you will reflect that back at them, potentially having them kill themselves. When you get to level 8, this is a no-brainer. You definitely want to take Blight Town to increase the Desecrate radius by 50%. If you don't have Blight Town, then this is just an either-or. At level 9, I take Defender's Dare for the increased shield throw damage. And at 10, since I'm not using Abyssal Form primarily as a damage-dealing ability, I'm going to take Pitch Black. For equipment, since I'm not taking Last Light, I need a way to regen health. So my lowest activated piece of equipment is going to be one that has health regen on it. The second piece of equipment is going to be something that increases attack speed. And the third is very important. I want a piece of equipment that provides healing received and or healing power. That's going to give a boost to the healing effect I receive from Abyssal Form. Couple pieces of advice for capture maps is don't be over aggressive. This one is tough for me because I generally am an aggressive player, but if you're running up to a point and see 2 or 3 players, put up your shield, block the damage, and back away. Try to get back to your team, or possibly one of the other players will try to chase you down and break from the pack so you can just lead them away. Another thing, don't chase players down. Most of the time what is going to happen is you're not fast enough to catch them, you're going to chase them all over the place, and you're going to end up running into more players. Now, in Incursion maps, you can actually change these skills up to make Galilea into a supportive healer and ranged attacker. At level 1, take Herald's Return. What you're going to be doing at the beginning of the match is running up, using Desecrate, then falling back to use your shield to hit enemies. No way. Getting up from that. At level 2, take Skilled Throw. At level 3, I'm going to take It's Dangerous to Go Alone. This throws 2 blasts of energy, then on the third swing, a blast that throws out multiple projectiles in a spread. This is going to give us 2 ranged attacks, but since this is only at full health, we do need to keep at the back of the fight. At level 4, take Chaotic Infusion. Now, we are going to run up to the front of the battle, hit Desecrate, then fall back. Power play. And despite what the description does say here, it also heals you as well as your teammates. At level 5, we're going to take Last Light because we want to keep healed up so we can use the ranged blast. At level 6, take Dark Age to increase Desecrate for 3 more seconds, which is going to provide more healing for you and your teammates. At level 7, Mirror Light, again because we're going to be staying at the back of the fight, so we're going to be keeping our shield up a lot, blocking range damage. Level 8, 9, and 10 are going to be the same, taking Blight Town, Defender's Dare, and Pitch Black. I thought it was pretty cool that a character you would not expect to be capable of being a support healer is actually able to do it and to be quite effective. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, I would really appreciate it if you give me a thumbs up. It really motivates me to keep making videos for you guys. If you have not yet, please subscribe. Thanks for watching and have a good one, guys.
Contract signed. For all mercenaries moving out. Power play. Only 2 hostiles remain. Enemy forces at 40% strength.